Hey, good evening. Welcome once again to Coastwide Church Victory Bible Study. We are going to have a night tonight. I'm so pleased that you're joining us tonight or whenever you're joining us, because I'm going to start a series tonight for the next several weeks, month or so, maybe longer, who knows, as much as I waffle on, I guess, but about the kingdom of God and bringing an understanding to you about this profound truth of the kingdom of God. And so let's pray, let's have a word of prayer and commit this time over to Jesus. Lord, we just thank you for tonight. We are just hungry and thirsty for revelation from your word. And so, Lord, I personally yield myself to you right now, to the gift and to the anointing that you placed upon my life to preach this gospel. I thank you tonight that your people have taken a moment to prepare their hearts to receive from you. That, Lord, it's not my words that they need to hear, but it's your words in mine. And so I yield myself to you right now, and I thank you and I give you praise and give you honor for the word you're going to speak to us tonight. We do that in the mighty, glorious name of Jesus. Amen and amen. So I hope you've got your notebook, your pen, your Bible with you, and we're just going to, as I said, have a great time talking about the kingdom of God. So the old systems of this world, this kingdom of this world, I tell you, it's failing. It fails just all the time. It's not meant to succeed, this kingdom of this world, at all. The kingdom of God, it's a system that succeeds all the time, that carries the fullness of the blessing of God upon it in every way. See, Jesus' return, we're feeling the birth pangs of Jesus' return coming back. I tell you, you can just be conscious and be aware that Jesus is coming back, because stuff happening in this world is all pointing to the return of the Lord Jesus Christ. And so this system of this world, this kingdom of this world, it's just increasing in birth pangs. It's getting ready for the return of Jesus Christ, and so should we. Here's my question. Are you ready? I hope your answer to that is that you are. So what is the kingdom of God? Well, the kingdom of God is the rule of God. Or another way of putting it is the kingdom of God is the reign of God. It's where Jesus is allowed to be king. If we allow him to be king in our lives, then we're allowing the kingdom of God to be established in us and through us. It's in your spirit. And what it does is it affects your soul, and then it has an impact on your body as well. When we allow the kingdom of God to work in our lives and we're operating by the kingdom of God, every part of our being, spirit, soul, and body, all of it is being impacted and affected in a very, very real way. It truly is. Your spirit man is being enlightened, and your spirit man is being encouraged. Then your mind, your will, your emotions that make up your soul, it's also being affected. You're experiencing the great peace of Almighty God. And then your body is touched by it as well. Your body lives in healing and wholeness and wellness as well. And so the kingdom of God is also the government of God. So the government of this world, they honestly, come on, whether they're a democratic voted in government or what they are, they really don't know how to govern very effectively. It's way out of their court. Unless we've got spirit-filled, Holy Ghost, word, faith, men and women doing it, then we're in for a chance. But it's the government of God. It affects your health. It affects your relationships. It affects your finances. It affects every part of your being. When we connect ourselves and start to live by the kingdom of God, or the rule or the reign or the government of God, then I can assure you and tell you right now that things will go well for you. They truly will. That's what I have experienced in my life walking with God. When I choose to live by the kingdom values, when I choose to live by the kingdom reign and rule of Christ in my life, things go really, really well. So let's turn to our first scripture. It's in the book of Luke, chapter 17, and we're going to read from verse 20 through to 21. Now, when he was asked, that's Jesus. Now, when Jesus was asked by the Pharisees when the kingdom of God would come, he answered them and said, now the whole of Israel, they were looking for the kingdom of God. They were looking for this king to come from God that was going to rule and reign and set up government. But listen to the words of Jesus. He said, the kingdom of God does not come with observation. So you don't see it with these natural and these physical eyes. You're not going to see the kingdom of God as such like that. And nor will they say, see here or see there. For indeed, the kingdom of God is within you. Listen to those that last line again. For indeed, the kingdom of God is within you. So it's on the inside of us. It's in our spirit, man. It's not out here where we can see it. It's not a government that is run by men in buildings. It's a government that is run by God. It's a government that is reigning and ruling by the Lordship of Jesus Christ in our lives. So the kingdom of God, Jesus said, is on the inside of us. It's within us. Everything we need is in the kingdom of God. Everything, every answer to every prayer, every material thing that you need is living on the inside of you in the kingdom of God. So what a profound thing that Jesus is saying. You're not going to see it with observation. You won't see it's here or say it's there, because the kingdom of God, the rulership, the government of God is living on the inside of your spirit. And when you allow its rule and reign in your life, when you allow the government of God on the inside of you to rule and reign in your life, like I said, everything goes well. You'll be healed, you'll be whole, you'll be well, your finances will be great, relationships will be good. Why? Because you're allowing God to have the rule and the reign on the inside of your life. Profound statement. In Mark chapter 10 and verse 15, it says, assuredly, I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will by no means enter into it. So he's saying a couple of things here. He's saying, number one, you must receive the kingdom of God. Now, when you're born again, you receive Jesus as your Savior. But then you have to allow Jesus to be Lord of your life. When you allow Him to be Lord of your life, then you're actually allowing the kingdom of God to rule and to reign in and through your life. And so you must receive it. You must receive not only Jesus as Savior, but you must receive Him as Lord. And in my time walking with God, I have found this, that a lot of people are very, very happy for Jesus Christ to be Savior. Wow, I'm saved. I die, I'm going to heaven. And that's great. But something more profound and something more powerful is when you allow Jesus Christ to be Lord of your life. So what does that say? That's saying that when you allow Jesus to be Lord, you receive Him as Lord. What you're doing is you are yielding your life. You are giving your life to Him, and you're saying, Jesus, from this moment on, I'm not going to be ruled and reigned by my flesh. I'm not going to be ruled and reigned by my desires and what I want. I give you my all. I'm not giving you half of me. I'm not giving you three quarters of me. Jesus, I'm giving everything to you, and I'm inviting you to come and rule and reign and lead and govern my life. Because again, what I've found is this, is when I try to fit the kingdom of God into my life, the kingdom of God is huge. It won't fit into my life. And when I say my life, I'm talking about my decisions, the things that I want to do and be in life. But when I flip that over and I change that and I say, okay, Jesus, I'm going to fit my life into the kingdom of God. I'm going to yield my desires. I'm going to yield my wants. I'm going to yield the things that I want to do. I'm going to yield them to you. I'm putting my life into the kingdom of God. And as I do that, then I'm allowing the reign, the rulership, the government of God to operate in and through my life. And things will go well, no doubt. And he says, does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child. You know, I don't know, you tell little children things and they just have this innate ability in them to believe you. If you say to a child, okay, today I'm going to buy you an ice cream, they believe it. All day they're waiting for you to go and buy an ice cream for them. And right at the end of the day, if you haven't bought the ice cream, they're still believing that you're going to get them an ice cream for the day. Now, when they grow up and to be older and that, they get a bit more cynical. But young children are amazing. They believe what they're told. You say to them, I'm going to buy that ice cream, then far as they're concerned, they're already licking that ice cream. And so he's saying to us, we need to come and receive the kingdom, and then we need to receive it as a little child. A little child just believes it. I believe that the kingdom of God, the rule of God, the reign of God, the government of God is living on the inside of me because I haven't tried to work it out and reason it out and try and do that with sense knowledge. I'm doing it like a little child. I believe it. I believe that there's the rule of God in my life. I believe that God is ruling my life because I've yielded my life to Him. Now, come on, I'm like most of you. I take it back every now and then and make a few decisions on my own. And mostly those decisions don't go very well at all. And so you have to come back and you have to repent and receive that kingdom to be established in your life. And allow the kingdom of God to rule and reign and the government of God to have its way in and through your life. Now listen to Matthew chapter 3 and verses 1 and 2. In those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the wilderness of Judea and saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So John is saying to us, listen, there's a prerequisite here for the kingdom of God coming into your life. And that is this word, repent. Now, most of Christians don't really understand what this word repent is all about. It's yes, it's changing, it's thinking in a 180 degree direction, sure. And it's not so much as crying out with tears and so on before God. Biblically, this word repent, where it says, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So the kingdom of heaven is at hand. It's right there. It's ready for you to receive. It's ready for you to draw onto the inside of you and allow it to be established on the inside of you. And so he says, for that to happen, you must repent. So the kingdom of God is the kingdom of heaven. Now, the Amplified Classic Version, it says this. It says to think differently, to change your mind. So this word repent, it's saying this, it's thinking differently. It's changing your mind, which has a powerful impact then on your emotions and on the attitude of your heart. And then it comes and it affects your words and it affects all of your actions. So the Amplified says this, think differently or change your mind. And that's what this word repent means, is that you and I, we need to think differently and change our mind. So many today, they're trying to live as a Christian by the world system, by the standard of the world. One of the standards of this world is that you might buy and sell. But the standard of God's kingdom is this, is to give and receive. Totally the opposite. Now, it doesn't mean that you can never sell something, absolutely not. But the whole system of this world is about buying and selling and trying to get ahead. Whereas the system, the kingdom of God, is about giving and receiving. So the kingdom of God often is totally diametrically opposed to this world system. And the way it is, the world, the system of this world is get ahead at any cost. Doesn't matter who you walk over. It doesn't matter what you have to do, lie, cheat, or steal to get ahead in life. But the kingdom of God says, no, don't do that. Promotion comes from Him. Promotion always comes from God. So He's the one who's wanting to promote us. So it's not being nasty and getting over the top of people. No, no, it's having compassion, it's having love, it's having honor, it's having kindness and respect for people. That's what the kingdom of God is all about. The kingdom of God is about loving people and forgiving people, whereas the kingdom of this world says, I'm going to get you back, I'm going to find a day when you're not waiting for me, and I'm going to take revenge on you, and I'm going to get you back. But that's not the kingdom of God's system. He says, love people. He says, forgive everyone of everything. It's like, ah, no, you said it, didn't you? Forgive everyone of everything. Yeah, that's the kingdom of God. That's how the kingdom works. Because when you forgive, you're forgiven. And it's an amazing thing to be able to forgive people of wrong. It releases you. It releases your spirit. Your spirit can feel like you're in a prison. But when you forgive someone, there's a releasing that happens on the inside of you. And it brings great joy into your heart. It really does. So the kingdom of God is at hand. And He's saying, for that to happen, think differently. Think about, I am allowing the rulership, the reignship, the kingdom, the government of God to rule in my life. And so therefore, I'm going to have to live by the principles of God's word, which has established the kingdom of God. Listen to Matthew chapter 4, verse 17 in the Amplified Classic Version. Matthew chapter 4 and verse 17. From that time, Jesus began to preach, crying out, repent. Remember, it says this, change your mind for the better. Heartily amend your ways with abhorrence of your past sins, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So again, the Amplified is saying to us, come on, you've got to change your mind here. You've got to think differently about God's system. You've got to allow the word of God, where it says in Romans chapter 12, that it's got to change your thinking, renew your thinking. Well, I no longer think about getting revenge on people who have done me wrong. I used to. I used to think a lot about how am I going to get revenge on people and do them harm for what they did to me. How am I going to make more money than I actually should, and all these crazy things. So when I got born again, and I had to repent of my old ways, repent of my old thinking, and renew and change my thinking, so now I'm thinking kingdom of God instead of kingdom of this world. And that completely revolutionizes your spirit, your soul, and this body in a great way. The kingdom of God is the way God does things. It's as simple as I can put it. The kingdom of God is the way God does things. It's His system of doing things. God does things different to how we used to do things. The way that we used to live and the concepts we lived by and the thoughts we lived by were just totally opposed to the way God does it. But now, as we repent and allow the kingdom of God to be established on the inside of us, now we think differently. If you asked my wife tonight, I think so completely different to the way that I used to think. Absolutely. Why? Because I allowed the kingdom of God to be established in my life. I allowed the rulership of God to happen in my life. His ability to govern and to lead my life has revolutionized and changed my life. So God does things different. Jesus did things different as well. Jesus went around preaching the gospel, healing the sick, raising the dead, doing things that were unheard of in those days, teaching truth wherever he went. In opposition to God's system is the world's system. And when we're born again, we operate, or till we're born again, we operate in the world's system. See, education taught us to live that way. Education taught us to live by your physical senses. Education taught us to live just simply by worldly knowledge. But the kingdom of God is teaching us to live by spirit knowledge. It's teaching us to live by the word of the living God. It's teaching us to be aware of the realm of the spirit that lives on the inside of us, is in around us. That we can, by the spirit, we can get words of knowledge from the Spirit of God. We can minister in healing from the kingdom. See, their kingdom of God, that's the kingdom of God's system. You see the sick, lay hands on the sick and they recover. He said these signs will follow those who believe. Believe what? Believe in the kingdom of God. You'll lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. You'll cast out demons by the kingdom of God's system, which is simply allowing his rulership, his reigning, his government on the inside of our lives. And so we get born again. And what needs to happen is we need to get educated in God's system. And that's what preaching the gospel is about. That's what reading the word of God is all about. That's what is what communion time with the Holy Spirit is all about. Because, see, the Bible says that the Holy Spirit is our great teacher. He comes to reveal things to us. He hears what Jesus is saying, and then he repeats it to us. And he brings rhema, he brings revelation from the Word of God to us. We can be reading it, and then all of a sudden something leaps off the page at us. Something is just like comes alive to us in that moment. Because we're starting to get information from the kingdom of God that will change our lives. See, being born again but still operating by the world system, that's not a great way to live. And I think there are too many Christians that are doing that. Yes, we praise you, Jesus, glory to God. We come to church and we do a few things like that. But predominantly, they're still making decisions for themselves. Predominantly, they're still not allowing the rule and the reigning and that rulership of the government of God to happen in their lives. They're still making decisions on what church they'll go to instead of saying, God, where do you want me to go? They're still making decisions on their finances. They're still making decisions on what job they work in. They still make decisions on where they live. All of these things, God has a plan for us. Jeremiah 29:11 tells us that he's got plans and purposes, amazing plans for us. But until we allow the kingdom of God to rule in our lives, we're not going to catch a hold of those principles and lifestyle that Jesus has for us. I want to say to you that allowing Jesus to be Lord of our lives is just the most amazing things. Stop making decisions for yourself. I believe one of the biggest issues in the body of Christ today is people going to the church that they want to go to. Wow, this church has got great music and all this other stuff. Let's go there. We'll go there. And yet what's God saying? Maybe he's saying to you to go there, and if he is, go there. But if he's not, go where God is calling you to go. Be in the place where the Spirit of God is leading you to go. Not by what you see with your eyes, great music, great preaching, great this, great location, all that. No, no, no. Be led by the Spirit of God, because that's how Kingdom of God people live and operate, is by the Spirit. See, we are in this world, but the Bible says we are not of this world. What does that mean? It means that we're living in this world, but we don't live by the system or the kingdom of this world. We don't live by the government of this world. We live by God's government. We're in this world, but we live this way. We live by truth. We live by the Word. We live led by the Spirit of the living God. They're the important things for us to live in the kingdom of God. So we're in the world, but we're not of the world. We have to think differently about this world. You can't have one foot in God's way and then the other foot in the world's way. No, no, no. We try to get delivered by the world system. We try to come out of discouragement or depression by the world system. We try to get money by the world system. We try to get healed by the world system. But every one of those things, to be delivered, get money, to be healed by the world system, every one of those things will let you down in some way. They may have a measure of success about them, but they don't bring the fullness of success that the kingdom and God's way, God's rulership does in our lives. If you want money, then start to handle your money by the kingdom of God. You want to be healed, then be healed by the way the kingdom of God says. Do what you need to do in the natural, eat right, exercise, do all that sort of stuff, and then put your faith in the Word of God and see the Word of God work in and through your life. Let me finish tonight with this verse of Scripture, and this is where we'll take up from on Thursday night, is Matthew chapter 6, verse 33 from the Amplified Classic Version. It says, but seek, now we could read it this way, but you seek, aim at and strive after first of all His kingdom and His righteousness, His way of doing and being right. And then all these things taken together will be given or will be added you besides. He will add things to you. We won't have to go trying to add things to our life, trying to do things that will cause us to succeed and do things to be added to our lives. No, no, no. He says, if you will seek His kingdom, seek, aim at, strive after first, not second, but first. Then He said, I'll add all these things to you. You won't have to seek after things. You won't have to seek after possessions and seek after money and seek after all these things. He said, I will add it to you if you will put My kingdom first. If you'll put seeking My kingdom, thirsting and hungering to live the way God wants us to live with Him as our ruling and reigning partner in life. Then He says, I'm going to add. I'm going to add. I'm going to add. I'm going to keep on adding things. You won't have to be concerned about a house or a car or food or clothes or a job, because when you're seeking first the kingdom, then God's going to be adding all of this stuff to you besides. And that's where we're going to launch off on Thursday night. So I want to tell you, you do not want to miss Thursday night when we start on this, because there's some things that the Spirit of God has got is wanting me to talk to you about this seeking first the kingdom. Seeking first, allowing the reign, the rulership, the government of God to be in your life. If you want to live a life that is successful, you want to live a life that is healthy, a life that is prosperous, a life that is just good, then seek first the kingdom, the way God wants you to live, how He wants you to be, what He wants you to say, who He wants you to be connected with, all very, very important things. Well, I hope you've got something out of this tonight as we just start this study on the kingdom of God. I just will have so much more to say about this over the next several weeks. You do not want to miss a session of it. You need to text and send a message to your friends, to your family, and say, hey, you need to come and listen. It'll revolutionize your life. It'll take you from where you are, and it will lift you higher into another fresh realm of God, I guarantee it. Let's have a word of prayer as we close tonight. Father, we thank You right now for the kingdom of God. We yield to that kingdom. We give ourselves over completely and wholly to the kingdom of God right now, to Your reign, to Your rulership, to Your government in our lives. And so, Lord, we thank You that as we seek first that in our lives, then everything we need is being added to us. We never have to be concerned or worried that we'll miss out in any way, because you are adding to us, Lord. And we bless you and we honor you and we praise you for that tonight. And we thank you for the book of Corinthians that tells us that we walk by faith and not by sight. We bless you and honor you, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hey, I bless you tonight. I bless you, I bless you, I bless you in the name of Jesus. And I pray that you have the most wonderful night, the rest of it now, and then the rest of the week, and we'll see you on Thursday night. God bless you. Enjoy being in the kingdom of God.